I'm back with another video, baby. I really just wanted to do that. I've always just wanted to do that. Y'all don't know, that is Teependale. I put his stuff down below, but that is actually his intro to a lot of his videos on YouTube. If you do not know who that is, please go check him out because he is hilarious. So I just wanted to do that. It's not going to be permanent. It's not going to stay, but I got that out of my systems. So we're going to be talking about Virgos today. We're going to be talking about the Beyonceans today. If you are dating a Beyoncean and you want to know how to get across that learning curve, boo, then stay tuned because this video is for you. Be clean. Be smart. Be classy. Be clean. Virgos do not like nasty, honey. Like, if you are dressed nasty, you're not, you know, sharp, and you got dirty, nasty fingernails and matter and crud all coming down your face, you might as well just let that go because they do not respect anything nasty or half done. And they are very critical, so they're gonna talk about you. They're gonna let you know, and your feelings are gonna be hurt. Virgos are very conservative. They're earth signs, so they're very down to earth, conservative, very practical people. They like things done very practically, and they're perfectionists. So they love perfection. They love things done right. If they're trying to do something and they have a goal for it, they want it to be done right. They're gonna really, really practice and you know, do all of the things that it's gonna take to get to where they want to go. Shout out to Kobe Bryant, rest in peace to the late great Kobe Bryant, who was a Virgo. He actually had a lot of Leo in his chart because his birthday was on August the 23rd, and Libra, Leo starts on, I believe, August the 21st or the 22nd. So he has a lot of Leo in his chart, hence, you know, the ball hog thing. Leos are all very about me kind of things. He is a Virgo, and a lot of you, if you've noticed, that he is very you know, he perfected his craft, and you know, that is that Virgo energy, that perfection, that I want things to be done right, so I'm gonna go the extra mile. Beyonce is the same way. You know, most of her stuff is built off of perfection. That is why she is such a large cultural icon, because you know, all of her things are very precise and perfectionate, and she puts a lot of time and work and effort into it, and she's not gonna stop until, you know, she gets it right. So the rule here is to don't overpower and or underplay. You know, they don't want somebody that's gonna be trying to tell them what to do and boss them around, but don't be a doormat. Always try to be a good sport, you know, have very good sportsmanship. They really do respect that. And they're very health conscious people. You will rarely ever find a Virgo who is not health conscious, or they don't like, I noticed that a lot of Virgos don't like processed food. Like, if they're gonna eat badly, they're gonna have the best of the best. They're gonna have, you know, the best cut of steak. They want things cooked fresh and hot. Like, they want their food to be just right. You know, a lot of Virgos are very health conscious. They're probably one of the few signs that would go on like a juice cleanse or a vegan diet. You know, something very earthy and clean and health-wise, health conscious. So if they invite you out to a all vegan restaurant or a you know, a farmer's market or something like that, then that's their thing. Be down for it. Don't turn it down, because that's just who they are and what they do. Virgos are very culturalistic. They like and admire you know, very profound works in culture. They appreciate things like that. They like exotic, different things that nobody's really talking about, and they really kind of just study it and bring it, you know, bring it into fruition. So naturally, Virgos are drawn to intellects, intelligent people, people who are actually going to be able to sit down and actually talk about something. They're not going to be talking to you about bullshit and you know, who's wearing the nicest shoes, and they're not really gonna be focused on that. They really like things that have substance and a value, so they appreciate stuff like that. So maybe like a museum or an art show or maybe even a sermon, a church sermon. You know, they like things that have some substance. They don't like noisy, crowded places, you know, maybe like a club or a strip show or something like that. They don't want to watch anything that's offensive or vulgar. You know, they love very soft, serene, simple, mind-stimulating type of entertainment. They have good taste. They're good taste, and they have pride in that. So they don't want to do anything that's going to discredit or you know, fracture their reputation or their image. Virgos are worrywart tonight. They are worrywarts. They worry a lot about things, which is one of the reasons why they are so big on perfection, because they worry a lot. They think they really do analyze every tiny little small detail of what could go wrong, you know, what isn't right. You know, they're very prepared in that way. Is it gonna rain today? How is this gonna affect me 10 years from now? If you wanna buy them a gift, please get them something that they can use, or something that they're gonna use. If they're not gonna use it and it's not practical, they don't feel like there's any way they can use it, they're not gonna appreciate it as much as they would if, you know, you gave them something of value. You know, a coffee cup, a car, or, you know, what else? Just things that they can use. Don't give them like bougie, ratchet gifts. You know, like on Valentine's Day, think outside the whole roses, candy, balloon, stuffed animal box, because they're like, eh, it's too gaudy and too, it's very unuseful for them. They're very big on planning. They don't like the spur of the moment kind of thing. Maybe every now and then you can kind of catch that in, but for the most part, they like to do things very planned and practical. Remember, Virgos are earth signs, so they're very, you know, kind of stuck to the ground. They don't want to do anything that is, you know, off the wall crazy. And, you know, if you are dating a Virgo, let them plan the date. You know, let them kind of figure it out, because they're very good at that, and they pride themselves on, you know, coming up with things that are going to be fun, like fun, but comfortable for them. So, you know, please be sure to always check out your rising signs, your other planetary signs, because these all do play a big role in the overall personality of the person that you're dating. And like I have said before in my previous video, if it's not for you, it's not for you. Don't try to make it work. You know, move on, change your mindset, or what have you. You know, you don't have to stay in something just because, you know, you think that this is just all that you have to have. So always think about that. So I am out, you guys. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please be sure to thumbs up, because it shows YouTube that, you know, this is where it's at and you know what's going on. So I appreciate you guys, and I will see you guys on the next video. And until then, peace.